So as I mentioned in the previous video, we're going to be approaching this project through baby steps. Okay. And the baby steps version of this project is, I mentioned this a little earlier too, one piece at a time. Okay. So in this case, if since we're using a food to make a big like scramble of food, right? We first need to learn how to draw one of those foods. Okay. It's going to be up to you. I'm going to give you 6 options that you can choose from, right? But you need to learn at least one of them. You don't need to learn all 6 of them. Okay. You just need to know one of them. And then once you learn that one food, you're going to take that food and you're going to master it. Okay. You're going to get so good at that food. You can then draw it in all sorts of different angles, all sorts of different sizes, and you're gonna decorate it to personalize it, okay? To make it the type of food that you want to make, right? So if you don't wanna draw sprinkled donuts, but you wanna draw like a chocolate syrup donut, do that, okay? If you don't like, if you don't wanna draw like a hamburger, right? Then draw pizza. If you don't like pepperoni pizza, then draw mushroom pizza. You know, it's up to you, right? But first you need to draw that one type of food, right? So if I'm going to go with the pizza example, right? Which I'm going to be teaching you how to draw in a second, right? First, you need to learn how to draw a regular plain cheese pizza. That is the most plain pizza there is, right? And then once you learn how to draw a plain cheese pizza, you can start to add toppings, right? You learn how to draw pepperonis on it. You learn how to draw mushrooms on it. You learn how to draw olives on it. You learn how to draw, anchovies on it if you want, right? It's up to you, okay? It's up to you what you want to put on the pizza, but first you need to draw the pizza. And then once you get that, once you can master that one type of food, you're going to build it up, okay? You're going to build up that drawing that I was talking about. You now are successful at one. Now that you're successful at one, you're going to put another one next to it. Right? Not just that same one, but a different version of that one, right? Let's say you drew a pepperoni pizza slice. Now you're going to draw a pineapple pizza slice, and then you're going to draw an anchovy pizza slice or whatever, right? Next to it. And then sooner or later you fill this entire page without even thinking about it. Why? Because you knew how to draw the individual pieces and you built up your drawing. Okay. So let me go ahead and show you what I'm talking about, right? So if we're looking at this donut piece, right, I started with this area here. I started with one donut at this angle. Then I learned how to draw a donut at this angle. Then I learned how to draw a donut at this angle. Then I learned how to draw sprinkles on my donut. Then I learned how to draw like glaze on my donut. Okay, how do I make it chocolate instead of vanilla or sugar, right? How do I do chocolate sprinkles instead of rainbow sprinkles, okay? All these different things. I had to learn how to draw separately, okay? But it's all based on the first block, the first building block of a regular donut, okay? So for this lesson specifically, we're just gonna be focusing on learning how to draw that one specific thing, that one specific food, and then mastering it.